안녕하십니까?
Hello, I'm Dr. Son Yong-hee from Ijeon Dental Office. Today, I'm going to talk about how to minimize bruising and swelling after implant surgery. After performing surgery, if a patient comes back on the next day, all swollen and can't open the mouth, the problem would make us all flustered. Such bruise or swelling sometimes cannot be avoided, but we can do something to our patients to prevent or to reduce the risk. Postoperative bleeding and swelling. As you can see, we don't want to face a situation like this. Let's have a look at a paper that came out in 2003. Clinical complications with implants. The incidence rate of bleeding with implant treatment is 24%. Causes: artery incision in soft tissue or artery in bone is damaged, sublingual tissue damage after lingual plate perforation in mandible, or infraorbital artery in sinus or posterior superior alveolar artery intraosseous anastomosis is damaged. Bleeding occurs when tissue and vessel are damaged together or independently. And in order to perform surgery, if we make an incision and raise a flap, swelling and others can occur. Swelling and edema. Because of inflammation or tumor, swelling or pus can be made. Edema occurs when plasma is accumulated a lot in the loose interstitial space. Therefore, what occurs after surgery is edema. Edema would be the right word. Swelling means inflammation, and it can also occur during healing. They can lead to difficulty in food intake and oral hygiene management and would delay normal healing. It can also lead to the secondary infection. The causes: excessive dissection of a flap. If you want this size flap but dissected too much, more edema would occur compared to a smaller size flap. Subperiosteal or subcutaneous hemorrhage. And when they are not properly managed, bleed would fill up the space, leading to swelling or edema. During surgery, if tissue is damaged or if you pull on the tissue too much, plasma can come out too much. During local anesthesia, injection can also cause them. Excessive bleeding or allergy can be the causes. To prevent or to manage them, what can we do? First principle is a traumatic surgery. We need to minimize the damage or injury. So excessive flap design or dissection should be avoided. During surgery, excessive pulling on a tissue should be avoided. During surgery, when we pull the flap, we pull the lip together. So after surgery, you can find the lip all swollen up. So we need to do the retraction very gently to avoid damage to tissues. Compression dressing is a must. We need to do it carefully. Early cold pack should be given for up to 48 hours after surgery. Patients need to be trained on using the cold pack. We need to minimize the needle injury during anesthesia, should use the least number of needles. If injection causes swelling, incision and flap opening will also lead to swelling. To manage them and to minimize them, we can easily get the effect using steroid for a short period of time to reduce swelling or edema. Hyaluronidase local injection is also introduced these days. As for steroid, dexamethasone is something we use quite a lot. So on the day of surgery, in the morning, 9 milligrams, one day after, 6 milligrams, and 2 days after, 3 milligrams are administered, but that is a bit too much. So actually, 3 to 1 milligram would be good enough. So small amount of steroid would not really require tapering. So after surgery, 2 or 3 times for 3 days, 1 or 2 milligrams can be given, which doesn't really require tapering. Next, hyaluronidase can be locally injected. Hyaluronidase, I believe you already know, this is used a lot to dissolve cosmetic filler when it goes wrong. So it is used the most to dissolve cosmetic filler. But if it is used with a local anesthesia, actually it increases the penetration rate quite considerably. So anesthesia works really well. So this is used with anesthesia. It facilitates resorption of bodily fluid or blood excessively present in tissue. So it can reduce edema quite a lot. It should be noted, it should be injected subcutaneously. IV injection is not allowed. This has not been used a lot because of the purity problem. The purity of hyaluronase used to be rather low, and it is in the powder form, so it should have been mixed with the saliva. So in the dental office, it was not easy to use them, but now liquid hyaluronidase is available. So using this, edema can be managed or reduced. I use it myself, not every time, but for extensive surgery or when a patient has a history of severe bruising or edema. After surgery, I use this. In this patient, we experienced severe edema previously with GBR, so at this time, I opened the site to place an implant. So I expected a severe edema and implants were placed. 1500 units. It just fills 1cc insulin syringe. So this is subcutaneously injected with the local injection. So at each point, they're injected. This will facilitate the resorption of bodily fluid and blood. So we can gain considerable effect in reducing swelling after surgery. So I have introduced some of the methods how to manage them. Post-operative edema cannot be avoided, but there are some ways to manage them. Basically, compression dressing or cold pack can be used. Next, steroid can be used. When it is used for short term, tapering is not necessary. So for a short term, like for 3 days, steroid can be used with a good outcome. Hyaluronidase can also be injected locally to reduce edema. Most importantly, guided surgery can be used so that we don't have to open a flap. Flapless surgery is a good way to reduce edema or swelling. So today, I've talked about swelling or edema that can occur after implant surgery. Based on that, I hope you give more comfortable surgery to your patients for implant surgery. Thank you for your attention.